Who I believe to be the true birthers of choosing beggars, it's entitled parents. Our first one is from Transbian 8787. For context reasoning, you have my sister 30, my dad 62, my mom 65, and myself 34. The neighbor 37 and her children, ranging in ages from 17, oldest son, to 9, the only daughter. Thanksgiving this year, my mom, a highly disabled and perfect mom in every sense of the word, spent 14 hours getting all the food prepared for everyone. She does this as a Christmas gift to us all. We buy everything and she cooks most of the smaller things. We buy a pre-cooked ham to make things easier on her. Around 2 p.m., the neighbor and her 7 kids show up, asking if they could join her since her husband left her and they have nowhere to go. He found out all but one kid wasn't his and has fled the area. My mom tells her there isn't enough food to go around for more than the 5 of us. She keeps badgering my mom, all of this taking place while my dad, sister, wife, and I are grabbing last-minute things and a huge thank you gift for my mom. Eventually, the kids push in and start making their own plates. My mom is in tears and finally just moved away from the door and calls me immediately. We rush home to find that nearly all of the food is gone via to-go boxes they brought with them, while they have gone home to eat our meal. My mom goes to lie down for a few and we call the police. An hour goes by and we wake my mom when the police finally show up. We explain the situation to them, show them the Ring doorbell footage of them coming and going and what was said, and the police say it's her word against the entire clan of trash, since my mom moved aside to let them through. They leave without letting us file a report, even having the nerve to tell us that we shouldn't do anything since the woman is having a hard time, and we should just be thankful we have each other for the holiday. On Saturday, all of us, mom included, are at the police station with pictures of the before and after meal, video with audio from the Ring doorbell, and wish to file charges against them for theft and elderly abuse and assault. The mom and her kids knocked my mom over on the way out. We also show the officer video of the interaction of the police response captured by my sister's phone. I'm just heartbroken as we spent all of our Thanksgiving in tears, consoling my mom and making the best of what was left. I'm so sorry those shitty and trashy neighbors put your mom through that, especially on Thanksgiving. I'm even more upset at the fact that the officer just said don't bother doing anything because the woman is having a hard time. So crime is justified if you're having a hard time, at least according to that officer. This next one is by 1875 OJ of C. This story happened quite a while ago, back when I was a newborn. My entitled uncle, who we'll call ED, and my entitled aunt, who we'll call Karen, which is her actual name, also had a kid who was the same age as me. Entitled uncle and Karen both had jobs, while my mom was a stay-at-home mom, and I was her only child at the time. They asked if my mom would be able to take care of their kid while Karen was at work, even offered somewhat reasonable payment. The arrangement went on for close to a year with no issues, until my mom got pregnant again. The pregnancy had started to drain her energy and she was tired more often. Karen was beginning to get unhappy that she had to start taking days off from work when my mom was unable to watch her kid. Eventually, this reached a tipping point. My mom started experiencing intense back pain and the doctor thought she may have meningitis. Obviously, she had to tell entitled uncle and Karen she was simply unable to care for their son anymore. They would not accept this for an answer. They said,
"We're paying you, so we demand that you watch over our son."
They didn't even attempt to sound sympathetic to my mom's condition and thought of her as merely a servant instead of their family member. Thankfully, we don't keep in touch with them anymore. I'm really glad that you guys don't keep in touch with them anymore because they're the kind of family that doesn't want to seem to treat family like family outside of that they owe them something. And that's not how you treat family. This next one is from Lowenmail Chen 03. My mom has COVID and is pregnant, so she's at home in her room and sleeps nearly the whole day. That means I and my sisters have to stay home from school and my stepdad does home office. My school doesn't do homeschooling, so I just have to get my materials from other kids of my class. This story happened yesterday. When I got up, I immediately went into the stable with my dog. I took the horses out on their meadow and made their boxes. Don't know what they're called in English. Then I fed the cows and cleaned the walkway of the stable. After that, I went back in. It took me about 2 hours to get all this done, and apparently my stepdad and sisters already ate. I asked him why he didn't call me, because last time he did and I ate with them. But he told me he thought I didn't want anything. Alright, so I made myself something and went into my room to eat. Not long after, when I tried to do schoolwork, he called me that I had to babysit my sister for a few minutes while he does something outside. He said 5 minutes, so I went and played with them. It was 3 hours until he came back. Later, he went grocery shopping with my youngest sister who's 4 and had to babysit my other sister, 8. My mom told me to brush her hair because my stepdad didn't do it for the last 2 days. So I did, and I tried to be gentle, but it was hard and she cried. In the end, my mom said give her a pacifier and I did, and when my stepdad came home, he immediately started ranting why she had a pacifier, even though he gives her one really often. So I told him and he started yelling at me until I ran into my room. That evening he cooked and I wanted something to eat, so I tried to cut myself some of the baguette he made, like these with herbs in them and such, don't know the name. And he told me I had to wait, so I got up and wanted to leave the room. While doing so, I let my arms sink to my waist, apparently too fast, because he started screaming at me. I didn't understand a word because he was so loud. I tried to flee and he threw a basket at me. That was when my dog started barking and growling at him, and I had to take her by the collar. At that point, I yelled back that I didn't even say anything. My mom came downstairs, and on the last two steps, she fell, but it was nothing bad. She's not even into the third month and also just fell onto her butt, so really nothing happened. When I fall like that or worse, my dog is the only one to come look if I'm okay. They don't care about that. But my stepdad immediately rushed to us and yelled at me more. I was crying at that point and my dog still growled and barked and tried to get him until I finally went to my room with my dog, who let me cry into her fur for a few minutes. When I was better, she licked my face. My mom came into my room shortly after, telling me I wasn't allowed to talk to him anymore and he wasn't allowed to talk to me. When I asked about something to eat, she went mad and I could take my own food, and in my age, her parents didn't treat her like this, which I don't believe. My grandpa is actually really close to me and I know him quite well. That's when I ran outside with my dog and tried to cool off. It worked, but then my stepdad wrote per WhatsApp that he had some of the baguette in the oven for anyone who wants it, and I know this was probably meant good, but I got so mad at that point. After I got home again, I didn't talk to anyone again until now. I'm trying to find out what the malfunction this stepdad has. Obviously, he needs some anger management because he's just an angry person, and the fact that the mom wants to stay with someone like that that mistreats her children, like, really, I don't understand shitty parents like that. And our final one is by UnfairConfusion8075. To start off, I have extremely bad anxiety to the point I'm on medication to calm myself and have been taken to the hospital because of my attacks and the harm to do to myself during them. And last year, I got my dog, a type of Mastiff, Pinky, verified as a service animal and trained to stop these reflexes as well as to warn others of attacks. She's licensed to be taken almost anywhere. My family traditionally does holidays at home, but last year in particular, a lot of people agreed to go, so we couldn't. Instead, we had rented half of a restaurant, paid by myself, as I do have a job, and my mother, though she paid the majority because at the time I was making half what I do now. My brother, his sister, my dad, my mom, my stepdad, my aunt, my girlfriend, my grandma, my great-grandma, and more had attended, but the one that caused the issue was my brother's new wife. I do not look anything like my brother, as he has red hair and green eyes, and I have dark brown hair and gray eyes, though my girlfriend has bright red hair, green eyes, freckles, and even got lip injections recently. We joke she looks just like my brother if she were a girl. Mind you, I must say I prefer she and they, and beforehand, said girlfriend was told he had a sister. The dinner had started nicely and everyone had ordered a special meal just for them, but the rest was an unlimited amount of food my grandmother had ordered ahead of time, and this was for Thanksgiving. My Tibetan Mastiff, Pinky, was sitting beside me and sniffing me every once in a while. My brother's wife has two kids, one of which wanted to play with Pinky, to which I instructed, "Please do not distract her, she's working." Well, the kid didn't stop and eventually told his mother that the dog wouldn't play with him, to which she told me to
stop being so stuck up and let your stupid dog play with the kid.
I informed her quickly that it was not going to happen because the room was loud and I hadn't gotten to take my medicine that morning. She scoffed at me and went back to eating, only to start sneezing a little bit later. When my brother said bless you, she shot me a dirty look and said,
"It's her damn dog. The damn thing is shedding so much and I'm allergic."
My brother was stunned and looked at me. My grandmother didn't seem impressed, but very reluctantly, my brother told me, "Look, I'm sorry for this, but would you mind leaving or taking the dog outside? She said she's allergic." I was shocked, and to the rescue came my girlfriend. "I'll take Pinky out now, love. Enjoy your meal." I couldn't believe she had gotten my girlfriend excluded from our meal, but not wanting to upset my grandmother, I continued dinner. Halfway through, one of my brother's kids let out an ungodly scream, and it seemed to have triggered something because I feel like I couldn't breathe. Every movement was pain, and when I tried to speak, my hearing went dead. I began to cry and I saw his girlfriend staring at me but not saying anything. I began to choke on my food and eventually, according to my mother, I had passed out. And it took her 4 minutes of me laying there with my head bleeding from hitting it on the table to say anything, as no one else had noticed. When I woke up in the hospital, my brother was sobbing and my girlfriend was nowhere to be seen. My mother informed me of what happened afterwards, and it turned out she had broken up with my brother because he yelled at her for waiting so long to tell us. And my girlfriend? She was at home with Pinky. When I got back with my mom, she and Booth just seemed glad to see me. This wouldn't have been such an issue if I weren't anemic, but I am, and even nosebleeds can be deadly for me. But I'm just glad now that my brother takes more care into who he dates and that I finally got on a daily routine of taking my medicine when I wake up. I forgot to mention above, but we are not supposed to bring kids because this was for teenagers and the parents. The fact that this entitled mom felt like it was okay for her kid to play with the service animal and then try to say she was allergic to it when her kid couldn't play with it, it just screams she wanted her way. Then I'm sure when all of this happened, she was probably complaining that her meal was ruined. I'm glad everything worked out in the end. Alright, that's enough entitlement for the day. Well, that wraps up this episode of Entitled Parents. If you liked the video, please drop a like, share my content on all of your social media. Subscribe if you haven't already and make sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time I upload. And drop a comment down below. It really helps with the algorithm and helps new people find my channel. Thanks for watching. Thanks to my patrons. Have a great day and stay safe out there.